What's up, YouTube? Redbeard's Garage, and welcome back to another video. Today, we're going to get to finally hear the mini chopper run. Now, I know people's been really eager to see this mini chopper get built, but I've had a lot of stuff on my plate, so I'm hoping to get to drive the mini chopper some today. We might just have to do it up and down the driveway because the brakes will not be done in this video. We are going to get that header made up and the engine mounted all down, the chain tensioned, and that throttle cable ran, and we should be good to go. So let's jump right into this thing and get it done. All right, so I didn't know that the bottom of that pillow block was kind of hollow because when I check these washers, the thickness of them, I just did it on the edge, so I had to cut one off, and I got these wider bearings I'm going to tack on there, so that'll grab the bottom of that pillow block. So I'm going to get these tacked up, and we're going to line that jack shaft pillow block. Okay, so we're back on the bike once more. So what I've done off camera was drill the holes for the motor to bolt up. It is all bolted to the bike, and I got those washers adapted with a wider washer like you had seen me weld a while ago. So we need to probably put the chain on, make sure where that pillow block's going to ride on the other side of the motor so we can tighten down the necks on it, the little collars, and then we can throw the chain on, and we got to make an exhaust. I do have a couple exhaust pipes all hacked up. I'm gonna build a little custom exhaust. It's probably gonna be open for the first run because I am waiting on a flange for my muffler. Now this is the muffler I'm going with. This is a black, it's got a 1.5 inch inlet, so it's a black little motorcycle muffler I bought it off Amazon. It's pretty nice. It's gonna sound a little bit like a motorcycle. Hopefully. Yeah, so that's what we'll do. We'll get now that the motor's bolted down where it's going to be, now I can actually start tacking up the exhaust and running it. And I do have a new spark plug wire made. Can you hand me that bad boy? So I did make a new spark plug wire with that MSD head on it, as you can see. And I used red 7mm solid core spark plug wire. There will be a video up in a few days on how to do these yourself. I like these because it's got the 90 boot on it and it says MSD. It's a nice little piece. You can use 8.5mm MSD wire, and I'll cover that in this video, but it's just a big pain. So we do need to pull the side cover off, slap this thing on. So just gonna look nicer and whatnot. We do have a lot more surprises that we can't talk about with this bike right now. A lot of things to come. Ain't that right?
Oh yeah.
You know, Lonnie's hopefully will come in within a week or so, and we'll get the build on his. But the plan is to try to, you know, get as much done on this as possible so we can start back on the four-seater. I know a lot of people's been wanting to see it, and we've been slacking on it a little bit. Well, not slacking. I mean, we've had other stuff to do. I just try to give y'all variety, and you gripe at me every chance you get. So
we really can't help it because garage isn't big enough to have this up here and be working on the four-seater.
Yeah, and that's the problem. We can only do one at a time. We have to completely stop, put everything up on the bike. So I'm trying to wind the bikes on the workbench. I'm going to try to bang out as much as possible. I don't think I'm really waiting on, yes, I'm waiting on that little collar for the exhaust. That's the only thing I'm waiting on, but we can run it with open exhaust. It's just going to be louder than a mother, but
we like loud.
Yeah, and I'm waiting on a throttle cable. I ordered, this is too short. The other one I have is way too long, but it'll work just for testing purposes only. So let's get to building this exhaust and getting that pillow block lined up. What do you say?
I'm ready.
So I got that exhaust flange bolted to the head really tight. Now I can pretty much mock up how I want this exhaust to go. And I've made lines with a Sharpie. All I gotta do is lay these in my vise and line up those lines, give it a little tack, then I can go test it back on the head. So I'm gonna get that done now and we can mock this all up. Basically, I'm trying to make the exhaust swoop out and then back around. It's about the only way you can do it and have room to take the nuts on and off. So I'm going to line these up in my vise and tack them all together, and we'll come back and show you how they fit. So I got that all tacked up. Now if I lay it on this gasket, and I'm going to have a little gap here and there that I'm going to have to weld up, it's going to put it exactly where I want it. Now, mind you, this exhaust is going to be covered with some exhaust wrap, some of that titanium exhaust wrap, as well as there's going to be a heat shield right here, just so you won't lay your leg on it. But I can pretty much tack that onto the flange now, and then, you know, tack it a couple times, then I can put it in the vise and final weld everything. But it's looking exactly how I needed it. So I am waiting on the adapter that goes from 1 inch up to this 1.5 inch that'll sit right there, and put my muffler, you know, pretty much exactly where I want it. I'm gonna get this all tacked up, and or all welded up, I should say, tack it to the flange, and then the exhaust will be done. So you can see kind of the swoop I was going for. Of course, all this is just tacked. I gave myself enough room around each bolt to be able to take that flange off. Now, when I weld on the side that the bolt's going to be, I'm probably going to take a die grinder and grind the welds down. But it's basically going to sit just like that, if you can kind of tell the shape of it. I like it quite a bit. And then this is my muffler, if you couldn't tell when I was holding it up. It's a slant cut black muffler, and it'll be pretty much like that. I'm probably going to angle the slant cut kind of like this, but yeah. So now we can put this in the vise and get it fully welded out. So I welded it and grinded all the welds, and I gotta say, it looks pretty nice. So that's where the muffler is going to sit. There is a coupler I ordered that goes from 1 inch up to 1.5 inch, so it'll fit inside the muffler real nice. But it looks pretty nice. As you can tell, it's away from the torque converter pulley enough so it can do what it needs to do. And it will be wrapped in exhaust wrap once I paint it. I'm going to paint it with some high temp black paint. But I think that looks pretty nice in my book. I don't know how exactly that muffler is just sticking in a hole right now, the little stud on it. But I don't know exactly how I'm going to mount the muffler. But it's going to ride pretty much like it is. But I like it. I like it quite a bit. So pretty much used a Go Power Sports header and an old eBay header that was pretty much just a 90 off of the flange. And you know, this is the original piece from the eBay. This is all Go Power Sports right there. So you know, work with what you have. And I still have extra pieces that, of course, I always keep those and throw them in a box for later exhaust builds. So exhaust is done. Now I can go to the other side and line up the pillow block. All right, I got to remove the side cover to put that new coil pack on. I had previously unbolted it. So it's just 2 8mm to get the coil pack off here. Come on, baby. All right, there's that old spark plug wire. Now I just got to pull out this kill switch line. Now we have our new one that we're going to slap on there. So I moved the camera on the other side of the flywheel so you could see kind of what I'm doing here. Now I'm going to put the new coil pack that I have made, because I didn't like that big bulky head. So I took some 7mm solid core spark plug wire and an MSD boot and put on there. I did shorten it quite a bit from what the stock length wire was. Like I said, I'm going to have a video on this in just a few days on how to make your own spark plug wire. So I'm just going to thread this on, and I can never remember the gap to put in between the coil and the flywheel, so I always use a business card, and it never has failed me. So let me get this snugged up and we'll put a business card in between it and set that gap. We got that gap set with that card. I'll snug that up. That business card will move out of there. Now we can run this kill switch up through these grooves that is made inside the casting of the block. Bend the tab down on the rear. Plug that spark plug wire in. And now we have a nice MSD spark plug wire. Put this side cover back in, four bolts, two up top, two down bottom. And this part is done. So the piece I was waiting for to finish the exhaust has came in. This is a stainless steel 1-inch to 1.5-inch little flange that I'm going to tack weld onto the end of the exhaust there, and that'll adapt up to this sleeve that goes inside the muffler, and then we'll tack the flange to the sleeve. So I'm going to get this all tacked on. We can align the exhaust how we need it after, you know, we'll try to hold everything up, line it up, tack it on, and I can pull the header off, fully weld everything. And then the only thing we got to do is make the exhaust hanger. I'm probably going to have to cut off this bolt that they've welded on, because I want the exhaust to set kind of sideways with the slant pointing towards the side on this muffler. So I'll have to come up with a new way to mount this, but we'll have to sand a little bit on this muffler, but we'll repaint it when we paint the back. So let's get this thing tacked. So that flange is all welded on there, and the muffler is just hanging where aroundabouts where it's going to be. I do need to cut this little bolt off and then make some type of a bracket to bolt that muffler up. I am going to probably grind these smooth, but maybe not, because it actually is going to be header wrapped. But it all looks pretty nice. Now we have to pull the engine back off after tightening it all the way down, because we forgot to drill the hose for the pillow block. Actually, we needed to bolt the engine down to mark where the pillow block was going to be. I'll take you around. So we also got that spark plug wire on, that MSD spark plug wire. It looks nice. Got the throttle cable ran behind the gas tank, and it comes out up there. So the throttle's all hooked up really nice. So the only problem with us riding this today is no brakes.
Never stopped us before.
May take it down to a straightaway. I don't know.
See what top end does.
It is going to be a little risky with no brakes. I mean, I've rode go-karts with no brakes, and you wouldn't think it would be risky until you ride them with no brakes. Because what if the throttle starts going?
The crappiest part's going to be coming down the driveway with no brakes.
Oh, yeah. I won't be coming down the driveway with no brakes. You won't either. Not on this bike. I don't want to tear it up. So I've got the places marked under that pillow block. So we have to pull the engine off, drill those holes. Then we can bolt everything down finally. And I need to run a little fuel line from there to the carb. And I am going to put a fuel filter in between that. So, and those aren't tightened all the way down. I need to tighten the barbs in this little cap all the way down. So we're going to get that done, and we'll pull the camera out.
Ride.
All right. So we have to notch out this piece of metal right here, because the chain rides right in this area, and I can't really adjust the sprocket much more than what it already is. So I'm just going to take a flap disc and grind a big hoop in this thing, and it should be good to to clear everything. So I'm going to get that done. But everything's mounted up, and I did put a oil line. Can you see the oil line on the camera?
Yep.
Put an oil line on there. So when we need to change the oil, we can pop that out, drain the oil, and I've modified the oil cap so we can pull it off. But jack shaft's all installed, everything's tight, and good to go. So we just get this chain marked out, we can throw some gas in it and ride it with no brakes. So we are now ready to start this thing. I'm gonna kill this if something happens by sticking the ground wire to the coil right on this tab. So just in case, this might vibrate a bunch of stuff on the table. That's the only bad thing. Got so much junk piled up, but the chain's tension. We have the fuel line on with the inline fuel filter. It does have gas down in it, so keep your fingers crossed. I took the choke off too early. The only thing that sucks is this is the kill switch. I mean, if you touch it to the handlebars or whatever, it'll shut off. But no brakes and no foot pegs. So I'm going to be riding this kind of once I get taken off. It should be okay though.
actually burned myself on the muffler. Yeah, it's not healthy on those spokes. It has a lot of power though. Power is definitely not a problem, for sure. Oh my goodness, she's fun.
Oh yeah, I can't wait till the brakes are on so we can actually see how fun she is.
And I like the way the exhaust sounds open. I mean, it sounds like a Harley.
Oh yeah,
pretty much. So wow. I can take the baffle out of that muffler, and so it's a pretty much just an open straight pipe. So I'll probably end up doing that because it quietened it down almost too much, I thought.
I did too.
It does, if you wide open throttle it, it does like fuel cut. It runs lean most likely, so we're gonna have to adjust that car, but man,
it's awesome.
Yeah, it's everything I thought it would be. I mean, I thought it would fly, and you can tell it would.
The only problem is with these stock bicycle tires, they got them little bitty spokes. That's sketchy.
Yeah, I'm pretty scared of these wheels and tires, which I am gonna convert it over to motorcycle wheels and tires, but I need to find something that'll work on the rear. I'm trying to go full legit motorcycle with this thing. What do you think?
I'll be doing the same with mine because I'm wanting to ride it everywhere.
Yeah, I'll ride it back and forth to work every day. I'll throw a backpack on and off into the sunset. We'll be the sunset riders.
Heyo.
Heyo.
If you don't get that, you're too young.
So there's still a lot to do. We got to wrap the exhaust. I did burn my leg on it like a retard. So I need to wrap the exhaust and put the... I got a little heat shield that'll go right where my leg touch, actually.
Brake, and I want the headlight signal.
Yeah, there's so much more to do. But there's more stuff we got to do to the engine. I forgot we're going to have to pull this engine back off. Charging cools.
Oh yeah.
And flywheel.
Yeah.
It's awesome though. For sure. I'm in love with it.
We got a taste of it today.
Yeah, now
we're addicted.
Now we can get back to the four seater. Now that we got to ride it. Now we're gonna have to take another break on this for a week or so. And but like I said, we got to ride it. We may take it down the road in a minute on this straightaway with a helmet, of course, and I'm not gonna full blast it, that's for sure. That's scary.
Take 3 miles to stop.
Yeah, burn up my shoes. I like everything about it though. I like how the throttle cable's hidden behind the gas tank. If you didn't notice that, it runs up behind the fuel tank and goes up right there. Everything's super nice on it. I am going to make an engine plate to go on top that'll hold the battery and fuse box, and then pretty much just get to wiring up all the lights. I'm so excited, dude.
Me too. ready for mine to get here.
So guys, I am pumped on this chopper build. I'm so excited to get this thing done. I can't wait. We got a lot more stuff to do. We got to do the headlight and the taillight wiring, and we got to make a little plate for the top of the engine to hold the battery and the fuse box. That's where it's going to be located because there's really nowhere else to put the battery. In the next episode, we're going to get all that, all the header wrap done and the heat shield on the header as well, and that muffler mounted. And then we should be able to tighten up a few things and actually go ride it on the road. We're going to get that brake all installed. I do have everything bought for the brake. I just need to go get a brake line made at my local Napa that's long enough to reach from the handlebars to that back caliper and then mount the caliper all up, and we'll go on a real ride on the road. We'll throw the helmet on and take it for a rip snot. Guys, let me know what you think of this chopper build in the comment section below. You can tell it's going to have a ton of power. I think it's going to have a lot of top end too. I'm really excited to get that brake done so we can really try this thing out. That Mikuni also does need tweaked a little bit because it does spit under heavy loads. So we'll get that adjusted out in the next video as well, because hopefully we'll be riding it on the pavement. Make sure to go check out Go Power Sports for all your go-kart and mini bike needs. They supported so much stuff on this bike. I can't thank them enough. Make sure to use that Redbeard discount code to save 10% on your purchase, and go get you some parts. Guys, make sure you go and like and follow us on Instagram and Facebook, where you'll get pictures of stuff before they come out on the channel. You would have been able to see this bike running before this video comes live on YouTube. And watch out for our live streams on Saturdays. We're not going to be doing the Wednesday live streams anymore. It was just a little bit too much live stream videos on my channel, so we're going to stick to just Saturdays and do an hour to 2 hours depending on how things are going. And come hang out with us and ask us some questions. Also, check out those Amazon links in the description below and the links on Go Power Sports, where you can get all the parts I use on this chopper build. If you use those links, it does help me out some and helps the build keep going, because these things are getting pretty pricey. We are going to be in Texas at Go Power Sports on April 21st through the 23rd. They're going to have an open house at Go Power Sports on the 22nd, so please come down and see me and Lonnie. We'll be down there and hopefully be riding some mini bikes and go-karts there at Go Power Sports. And we'll have some stickers and some other goodies for you guys to get. So if you're in the area, please come down and support the channel. And there'll be a lot of other bigger channels down there, so make sure you stop by if you're local. And guys, always come back to Redbeard's Garage. I'm out.